Hello, brothers. Guess where we are today? Okay? Today, we're outside Buckingham Palace. My friend, my guy Glenn, said, Joshua, when you get to day 150, where are you gonna go? Buckingham Palace. So I said, let's go for it. Let's do it. Brothers, day 150 on hard mode with God's help. We can do this, brothers. We can all do this. Absolutely. 100%. Everyone can do this. Gee, how am I making this video? There's so many people around. My goodness. My goodness. Let me get out of the way of all these people. So many tourists. Big tourist area here, Buckingham Palace. Absolutely. Earth is an amazing feeling. Absolutely crazy. Incredible feeling to be here, you know? And when you get here, when you get this far in your streak, there's one issue that you have to worry about. Overconfidence. Because at this point, right, your strategy is working. You have plans in place and your recovery is there. You're experiencing genuine sobriety. You've gone past 90 days. You're like, yeah, I'm doing this now. I am doing this. Yeah. See that in the background? Hey! But yeah, overconfidence. That's what we gotta worry about now. That's what we gotta concern ourselves with. We have to stick to our strategy. We have to stick to our plans that got us here. Don't think, okay, now I've passed 90 days, I've passed 100. I'm jumping off the forum now. I'm logging out of the WhatsApp groups. You know, I'm no longer going to connect with any people. I'm done. Addiction, bye-bye. Right? Because how it is that now you've made living this lifestyle a habit, right? It's a habit now. It's you're there every day working on not going back to that addiction. You've made living this clean, free life your lifestyle now. Right? But It's a new habit, right? It's a 90-day, 100-day, even up to a year. It's still, you had years of addiction. Years of addiction. And all it takes is just one set of images, one video that throws you out. You get huge, strong urges again, and you're back where you started. Right? You have to remember that we're always human. We're always going to experience that temptation. And for us, it's higher. Because everyone in the world, don't think that you're the only one that experiences temptation to view pornography. Even people that don't view it, they still are tempted to. They're still tempted. They're just a lot less tempted than we are. Right? Like they get, maybe theirs is like a curiosity temptation. Look, I wonder what it's like. I've never seen it. No, by the way, those people that have never seen it are very rare. Like less than 5%, you know, of people over 18. Like, it's very rare to have those people. But they exist, and they are tempted. Everyone is tempted. Now for us, our level of temptation is always going to be a lot higher because we were there, and we were addicted for years. A long time. So there is no, you know, I'm free now, I'm completely done. I don't need to learn anymore. I don't need to practice anymore. I don't need to connect with any other people. I forget my accountability partner. I've passed my my goal. No! You keep going, you connect even more. Now that you're on this side, you make sure that you're helping other people. Because helping other people helps you too. You remind yourself of all the lessons and the strategies that got you here. And it's sad looking at all the relapse stories and seeing people that are struggling. At the same time, it reminds you, yeah, that was me 4 months ago. That was me 5 months ago. I was seriously struggling too. I couldn't get past a week, you know? So those connecting with others in the community, it really helps you. And you have to keep renewing your commitment. Because our commitments, they run out over time. Over time, we forget the reasons why we're doing this. Because when you get to these levels, you're experiencing benefits. Huge benefits. And your life has changed so much in a short amount of time that you're like, there's no way I'm possibly ever going back. There's no way. And yes, it's absolutely possible for you to never relapse again. But you have to stick to your strategy in order to make that happen. And don't go all, you've gone all this way on your strategy and then switch back to willpower. No. No, it's not going to work. Because willpower runs out. Runs out. And now that, yes, you've made this lifestyle a habit now. You've advanced. But maybe now your willpower will last a month, or 2 months, or three. But eventually, if you don't stick to that plan, you're going to slowly start pushing the boundaries, slowly, like, it's only a bikini picture. It's only an Instagram model. It's only one GIF. Is it GIF or JIF? I don't know, man. Don't at me. There's only one. And slowly you're back on YouTube, like, this is fine. It's just a twerking video. It's not full on pornography. Oh, it's just a music video. Then bam, you're back. You're back in the addiction. Slowly but surely. Why? Because you forgot your plan. You forgot your strategies. You stopped connecting with other people. You stopped telling them, listen, I'm feeling urges. I know it's not urges to watch pornography, right? I know it's not urges to masturbate. But I'm feeling urges just to go on Instagram and browse. You know, let's see what I would find there. I'm feeling those urges. You stop connecting with other people. Can't be overconfident. Because that, when you get to a higher streak, that's the number one reason why people relapse. They feel like they've made it now. And yes, you have made it. Absolutely, you have made it. But you didn't make it here on your own. You didn't make it here without a strategy. You have to stick to it. That is what helps you keep making it day in and day out. You know? Like, let me tell you guys, day 150 benefits here are incredible. Let me give you my benefits now. I'm feeling a much deeper spiritual connection to God. My family and friends, my goodness, wow. It's like I went to war or something and now I've come back. So there's love, there's joy. Like, they haven't seen me in years. I'm a new person now. Like, even just yesterday, my friend was telling me, it's like I'm learning new things about you every day, because I hid so much of myself when I was when I was addicted. I didn't speak out about how I really fought the feelings I had inside. It's like, whoa, you're a different person. I don't even know you. This is exciting. Social anxiety is... I'm making this video in public. What do you mean? What do you mean social anxiety? Don't mess with me. Don't come to me with no social anxiety nonsense. That's gone, bro. That is gone. We fully confident out here. We thank God. Yeah, that I'm healthy. And just like 2 or 3 days ago, I ran 16 kilometers. Never done that in my life. Never. Now I'm thinking. Now people got me out here thinking about marathon running and stuff. I don't even know, you know. Yeah, I need to get on strength training at the gym. You know, weightlifting and stuff. I need to do that. But now I have the energy to do it. Energy, so much energy now. My goodness, this morning. Right, I slept like 3.5 hours? What? 3.5, 4 hours? That's how long I slept. That's it. Look at me. Do I look tired to you? No, I'm not tired, bro. Nah, we thank God. There's benefits on this side, okay? Female attraction, it's a real thing, it's a real thing. We on hard mode though, we don't really care, but it's there, it's just there. It's just that little extra big confidence boost, like, you know, it's a real thing out here, man. Benefits are real. We can all get to this point, brothers. Absolutely. Every single one of us. Everyone can all do this. Peace.